A canoe made of concrete? No, it's not the Flintstones. And yes, it does float. And several members of ODU's concrete canoe team made the nearly 50-hour, 3,000-mile journey across the country to tow the 300-pound canoe from Norfolk to San Diego to prove it.
We are here for the ASCE 2018 National Concrete Canoe Competition, and we're just out here to compete and have a good time.
They got in on a wild card invitation to compete against 24 other teams from the U.S., Canada, and China in the 31st Annual National Concrete Canoe Competition organized by the American Society of Civil Engineers. This year's event was hosted by San Diego State University.
It's kind of just a miracle how we're even here. I mean, it was kind of by chance getting the wild card slot. I mean, you know, we drove for 50 hours from coast to coast. Nothing happened. Nothing happened to the canoe. I mean, it's just a lot of it just worked out really well.
To qualify for the wild card draw, the ODU team had to score in the top third on their annual report, finish in the top 50% of their regional competition, and complete a statement of interest. 6 out of 32 wildcard qualifying teams were then selected at random by ASCE.
For ODU to see this is pretty awesome, and especially being the only school or university in Virginia is pretty great.
The teams design, build, and race concrete canoes for their chance to win the America's Cup of Civil Engineering, as well as academic scholarships.
We had to start by creating the canoe, obviously, and we had to order parts and cut things and finagle them into something that floats, that's made out of concrete. And we had to make this type of aggregate that's less dense than water and make it to where it's not too heavy so we can actually row in it, so it's not this giant brick in the water.
I would say that the challenge is concrete because it is kind of an odd thing to use in the water, because it really takes a lot of creativity and a lot of minds to make it happen. So it's not a one-man thing, and we've definitely needed every member of our team.
I always liked the concept of a concrete canoe because it doesn't make sense. And I know applying the things that we're learning can work, so I was really interested in that aspect.
Teams are judged on design and construction, a technical design report, a formal business presentation, and on several races.
There was a sprint. It was a 200-meter sprint. We were just two. And then you had a co-ed race that was 400 meters, and it was just four people. And then you had an endurance race, which had a slalom, and you'd do lots of turns going back and forth. Lots of straights, and that was 600 meters. And you do that for male and female as well.
Though the Monarch Tide didn't place in the national competition, Andrew said he was pleased with his team's overall performance.
Everything we thought about, everything we planned for, we're doing it, and it's working. And that was just awesome.
When 2014 ODU graduate and former concrete canoe team member Zachary Ryan heard ODU made it to nationals, he couldn't resist coming out to cheer the team on and to offer a few words of advice.
Every position that I've received, they say that, oh, the concrete canoe story was what put you above the next person. It's just experience that you get now that will help you later.
I learned a lot more about the design process and time management, and also how to work with people who have different schedules and somehow managing to get everyone together.
What I like most about this is I get kind of the full wrap of what engineering is. You get the communication with sponsors, and you get the communication with others and growing and learning from the people in the competition.
We grow together, we learn together. And I think that's, for me, the most exciting part, is doing that together.
For the Batten College of Engineering and Technology, this is Keith Pierce.